Our appetite for data is insatiable. In a digital world, watching videos, taking photos, or asking for directions means more data flowing into an invisible cloud. Yet this cloud is far less fluffy than we think. Cloud infrastructure is growing, occupying swathes of land and consuming huge amounts of electricity. Today, global data centers use as much energy as the entire UK. By 2030, this figure will rise to more than 20% of global energy. This has serious implications for the environment, with the data industry already emitting as much CO2 as aviation and set to grow exponentially. It seems we're heading towards a future of data warming. But imagine if the cloud could absorb CO2. What if servers could produce their own energy? What if data could be grown and cared for by communities? Grow Your Own Cloud stores data nature's way, in the DNA of organisms. We seek to create a new type of cloud, one that is organic rather than silicon, and which emits oxygen rather than CO2. This involves working with DNA data science. This technology has the potential to store all of the world's data in just 1 kilogram of DNA. It works with organisms that create their own energy. It stores data in a format that never grows obsolete. The data garden is a new type of infrastructure for DNA data storage that promotes harmony between people, ecosystems, and technology. The installation features plants encoded with data. The encoding process involves converting digital data such as text, JPEG, and MP3s into a biological format using genetic modification to convert from binary to ACGT. In the data garden, data stored within the plant's DNA can be decoded using the latest genetic sequencing technologies. This process is triggered by introducing a liquid sample to a nanopore sequencer, which analyzes the genetic information to reveal hidden messages, sounds, and images to be experienced in the space. Working with nature to alleviate the threat of data warming, the data garden invites visitors to explore a world in which data storage is truly green through self-sufficient data ecosystems. This type of data center makes data an accessible public resource, open and shareable within communities. We began this work through speculative explorations, transforming local flower shops into decentralized data centers. This familiar yet uncanny environment became a community gathering space in which people could explore what data truly meant to them, discuss the harmful effects of the current data industry, and debate the ethics of new breakthroughs in biotechnology. From the speculative prototype, we moved to reality, working together with scientists from the University of Washington Molecular Information Systems Lab to develop the data garden. Collaborating with Jeff Navala, a principal investigator at MISL, allowed us to develop a process to translate digital data into plant DNA. The big breakthrough is a novel approach to decode this information using real-time genetic sequences. Through this collaboration between the arts and science, the data garden emerged as a fully functional end-to-end DNA-based data server, which allows for autonomous live decoding of data from plants. This represents a new format for data centers, proposes a new materiality around data, and offers new models for community-led data production and access through partnership between humans, technology, and plants.